Hello, guys, and welcome back to another episode of Code Rhetoric with Tam Talk. So today I have the trusty dry erase board here to help me break down the neoplasm table. So I know this is, it seems very basic, but honestly, there is some confusion, or there could be some confusion as it relates to the neoplasm table and assigning our ICD-10 CM codes to the encounter. So I have written here on the dry erase board some tips or strategies to kind of help you gauge what ICD-10 code column you should be selecting as you are assigning your ICD-10 codes from the neoplasm table. So let's get started. So first we're going to get started with the malignant. So right up under malignant, you see I have primary and secondary. Now on the neoplasm table, the primary and the secondary also, they also has a column. However, I place it under the malignant table because we want to really talk about that. So for those of you who are familiar with the term neoplasm, typically that is more of like a biopsy pathology terminology. And also the term, when most people hear, they think of cancer, right? It's like, oh my God, cancer. So we're going to break down exactly what a neoplasm is and then get into the different categories. But like I said, we're actually starting with malignant. So with the malignant, this is pretty much, it is malignant. Typically, it is cancerous or has cancer tendencies. And so if it is cancer, then what stage or what is it, the primary site or is it the secondary site? Oftentimes, you'll see in documentation where the provider will state that the patient has, I'm going to use the example, colon cancer, a secondary stage, a secondary phase of colon cancer. The primary site is breast cancer. So when we determine what we should be coding based upon that, so if the physician is actually treating the colon cancer, which he did mention is the secondary site, then we're going to select our ICD-10 code from the malignant column, but we're also going to look at the secondary site or secondary ICD-10 code because it is the secondary site. So we will select our codes from there. However, if the physician is treating the primary site, which is the breast cancer, then we're also going to go to the malignant column, and we're going to select our breast cancer diagnosis from the primary site, again, because the provider mentioned that the breast cancer is the primary origin or the primary site, and then the colon cancer is the secondary site. So again, it all depends on what that physician is treating at that particular encounter. If he or she is treating the colon, which is the secondary site, because it's spread from the breast to the colon. Then we're going to go to malignant. Then we're going to pick up our ICD-10 code or diagnosis code from the secondary column. If it is the breast cancer that is being treated, we're going to pick up our primary ICD-10 code, excuse me, from the primary column. So now let's move to benign. So benign is the opposite of malignant, right? This person is malignant, so possibly it is cancerous. Benign is not cancerous, right? So we typically see the benign assignment or diagnosis as it relates to the integumentary or the skin system. It may be like adenomas or an uncertain pattern or behavior of a skin issue, and the doctor will do a biopsy and submit it to pathology to confirm whether or not that particular tissue or skin, what have you, is benign or malignant. So if it's not malignant and it stays benign, you're going to select your diagnosis code from the benign column and also based upon the anatomical site, as with the breast cancer and the colon cancer, right? So in this case, if it is integumentary or the skin system, you're going to look for that specific site within that particular skin or integumentary system, and it could also be, again, breast anatomical site, as well as intestine or colon. But again, it's all going to be based upon the documentation that we are reviewing for that encounter. And so more than likely, 100% of the time, we should be coding from the pathology report, especially when there's a biopsy involved and we're trying to determine the outcome or the final diagnosis of a patient. So the pathology report will tell us the definitive diagnosis of a particular biopsy, whether it is benign, malignant, which will proceed into thy next category, uncertain. Okay? So, uncertain behavior. Uncertain pretty much means the tissue is out. It hasn't been determined whether or not that particular tissue or specimen is benign or malignant. It's uncertain. It's giving uncertain behavior. It could possibly be benign. It could possibly be malignant. But we don't know because it's uncertain. So we're waiting for the pathologist to confirm whether it is benign or malignant. Then we're going to go to unspecified, which is, again, it is still pending, right? It's, again, we don't know if it's benign, nor do we know if it's malignant. It is uncertain. We did do the biopsy, but we are waiting the pathologist to confirm the diagnosis. Unspecified, we are still waiting. However, we're going to go ahead and assign an unspecified code until we get that confirmation from the pathologist. So in that case, again, it's all going to be based upon, one, the, I'm going to write this down, the anatomical location. And keep in mind, there are skin, you know, just in the different anatomical locations, right? Or tissue. Then it's going to be based upon, again, pathology report. The pathology report confirms the definitive diagnosis, whether it's benign or malignant. It may even determine if it's uncertain. It may be there, the tissue that the pathologist examined doesn't really give all it needs to give. It's still uncertain. Perhaps the surgeon has to go back and do tongue-tie, perform another biopsy, but it's still uncertain. And then unspecified, it's still pending, right? We still don't know. Maybe there's some growth that needs to occur, whatever it is that's going on with that patient's anatomical site or skin. It is uncertain and it is unspecified, but again, it has not been confirm whether it's benign or malignant. So more tests has to be performed before that is determined. So again, we want to make sure we're looking at we're selecting the correct anatomical site. And then next, we want to look at our pathology reports to confirm. Now, sometimes, depending on the organization that you're working for, they may not wait for the pathology reports. I don't know. There are some organizations that will need to get those encounters out, and they may forego waiting for the pathology report. In the event that the pathology report is unavailable and you're not pending those encounters, waiting for that pathology report, you may want to go unspecified, right? Because you don't know. You don't want to assign a benign or malignancy to an encounter without confirmation from the pathologist. Here's why. Not only does it affect the reimbursement from the insurance carrier, but it also may have other implications for that patient, such as life insurance. Life insurance, right? They may not be able to get approved for life insurance because you automatically assume and assign a malignant or benign diagnosis to an encounter that hasn't been determined by the pathology report or the pathologist. So again, you want to make sure you pay close attention to the anatomical site. Now with the breast. Now, there are different parts of the breast, as you see in the neoplasm table. So, the doctor will specify whether or not the specific site within the breast, as well as the colon and intestine in which they are actually, they retrieved the biopsy and that tissue was confirmed for malignancy or whether or not it was benign. So, we want to look at that, and they should document. And I'm going to add this to the anatomical site. They should add laterality. So pretty much laterality means, is it left or right? Right? Left or right. And then further indicate what part. Okay, so if we are doing the left breast, right? What part of the left breast? Right? What part of the left breast? So we need to confirm that. So in over my years of looking at reports, they are pretty specific as to the laterality or the details of the anatomical location in which he or she is retrieving biopsies, as well as confirming the pathology of said biopsy tissue. So yes, so they're, like I said, they are pretty decent, pretty detailed when it comes to that. In the event that you are reviewing an encounter or reviewing documentation, and it doesn't specify the anatomical location in detail, it is okay to query the provider for further information if it can't be easily inferred where he or she is actually working. And again, and I keep talking pathology report is the final determination of a diagnosis, okay? The pathology report. So I'm going to throw in a curveball. So what if the doctor does specify breast cancer as the primary site, right? He said we're just going to leave it there. It's just, he just states it's breast cancer, all right? And let's say we do have a pathology report, and the pathologist forgets to indicate whether it was left or right. So we know it's malignant breast cancer. So we may assign just a breast cancer diagnosis, and that will be unspecified. Now let's query the provider on whether or not, you know, the actual location of the breast cancer. Okay, there is actually one more that I just realized I forgot to add. The CA in situ. Let me spell that. CA in situ. CA in situ. In situ. In situ. In situ. Keep saying that. Okay, so that's another category that we need to discuss. And let's get into it. All right, so cancer in situ. C-A-N-C-U. And I know you keep hearing me like, okay, you keep saying that. So what is it? N-C-U. N-C-U. How did you come in? You know, to say come in and have a seat. N-C-U. So where did the cancer come in? So pretty much the C-A-N-C-U represents where the abnormal cell started. So they may be confined to their primary location. And again, we're going to use the breast as our example. So it started in the breast. It is currently located in the breast area. Excuse my spelling and handwriting here. Okay. So again, this is pretty much abnormal cells that are currently located in the breast area. And that's where they are temporarily. So we're going to call this like the nomad, right? The nomad cancer. So, however, although it is currently situated in the breast, that doesn't mean that it won't move, right? It may move to the colon, right? It may move to the intestine. It may move to, I'm just going to say it can move anywhere in the body. So pretty much, again, CA in situ is where you started, where you're currently staying, but that doesn't mean that that's where you will always stay. So in situ, you came in and you sat down here, and this is where you're currently sitting, but you may not stay there, okay? So another term that we often hear when it comes to the neoplasm table, so neoplasm in itself, when most people hear neoplasm, if they work in the health industry or if they've been in the health, around health, the health industry, the first thought is cancer. Neoplasm is cancer. But again, it could be benign. So neoplasm technically does not mean malignant cancer, like, you know, rigging ready to die, right? It just means, it's just a term for abnormal cells. Write that down here. Then we have carcinoma, right? That's another term that we hear as it relates to the neoplasm table. So you read the pathology report and say the patient has breast carcinoma. So we think, okay, they have breast cancer, right? So this is another term. You hear neoplasm, you hear carcinoma, you hear adenoma. So you see adenoma. You may say you see something like pseudo. And I'm saying pseudo tumor. And we know that if we have taken medical terminology, we know pseudo can mean fake, right? So it's pseudo, it is representing like it is a tumor, but it really isn't. It has the characteristics of a tumor, but it really isn't. So pseudo. Pseudo is things appearing real, like fear. False evidence appearing real. Pseudo. Right? So, yeah. So this is why it's important to wait for the pathology reports to determine the behaviors of our tissue that was biopsied. Again, that tissue could be malignant, it could be benign, it could be uncertain, it could be unspecified. And again, as you're reading the pathology reports, you see terms, again, such as neoplasm. You'll see things such as abnormal cells and tissue. You'll see terms such as carcinoma, adenoma, pseudotumors, and there are so many other omas out there. But these are just some of the most common ones that you'll see on the pathology report. And so, does all those terms mean the patient has cancer? Again, it depends on the encounter. I don't want to give you those, like, if you see this word, that means cancer. It really depends on a case by case. Again, on the encounter. But I just wanted to break down the different columns of the neoplasm table. Here, let's see. Write it down. So like I said, so we have malignant, we have benign, we have uncertain, we have unspecified, we have CA in situ. Remember, in situ. Where you started and where you're currently sitting, but doesn't mean that you will not move, right? So what are the things that we're looking for in the pathology report? Again, we want to make sure we have our anatomical location because the neoplasm is broken down by the anatomical location, right? Next, we want to make sure we're confirming our diagnosis with the pathology report. So we will look for the pathology report to confirm a diagnosis. Let's say our doctor does, a surgeon does perform a biopsy, and he may diagnose the patient based on what his knowledge is, but again, you want to confirm that with pathology. Again, because it could be uncertain, it could just be abnormal cells, carcinoma, adenoma, pseudotumor. Remember, pseudo is fake, right? False evidence appearing real, such as fear. So yeah, so hopefully this provides some insight into the neoplasm table. And yeah. So yeah, I'm going to go through it one more time. So we have malignant, benign, uncertain, unspecified, CA in situ. Again, we're looking for our anatomical location. It's going to be very specific. Although it is in the breast, we want to look for where exactly where it's located in the breast, whether it's the right or left breast, you know, whether it's in the areola area, whether it's in the duct. We want to make sure the documentation is very specific to the location. Again, as it relates to the primary and secondary, primary is where the cancer started. Secondary is where it spread it. And then depending on what is being treated, excuse me, I had to move my camera, depending on what's being treated at the encounter. So we use the colon for secondary, we use breast for the first, for primary. So if the encounter states that the doctor is actually managing the colon cancer, then you're going to go to malignant, you're going to go to secondary, and then you're going to go to colon, and you're going to pick up the secondary diagnosis. Because this is not the original spot where the cancer began or started. However, if the doctor is treating the breast cancer, and this is the original spot or the original space, you're going to assign the primary malignant code to that. And also, another thing that I failed to mention, you'll notice C's, right? For like your malignant, your unspecified, and your CA in situ, right? Your D's represents your benign, and your, I can't spell, and your uncertains, right? So yes,
I don't have an acronym for that. I don't have a little catchphrase for that. Just know that C is for, again, everything C related, and D is for benign or uncertain patterns or behaviors. So I hope this, again, brings some insight or shed a little bit of light onto the neoplasm table. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to drop a comment below. And as always, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Until next time.